Yeah, bub, it's just you and me.
All right, dude. Come on. What was that back there? Juicy fruit with cookie dough? Red meat with laundry detergent? You're better than that. I know I move fast, man. I know. But I need you to keep up with that shit. All right? When I get in the zone, I'm in the zone. Ain't nothing stopping me. You're gonna be getting cantaloupes and NyQuil, and I'm gonna need you to make it work. I didn't get to express by giving the customers bleach marinated hamburgers, all right? So I need you to get your head into the game and out of your ass. Are you with me there, buddy? Got the bag, boy. Do you copy? All right, man. I dig the stoic attitude. I'm gonna go hold down the fort.
I hope you don't mind, son. I have more than 15 items in here. I hope that's okay.
Yeah, whatever. It's fine. Let's get going. Excuse me, sir. Do you need any help with that? Excuse me, sir. Do you need any assistance?
Sir, I've been shopping for groceries for over 52 years. Every Friday, I used to walk 1 mile back and forth with 50 pounds of groceries on my back. In fact, one time, I had to walk through 17 feet of snow. And you know what? I enjoyed that. And you're gonna ask me one more time if I need help?
Okay, ma'am, your total is 175.
How much is the rice?
Which one? How much is which?
The rice. The rice. Deaf little shit.
Yes, of course. The rice. The rice is...
Hurry it up!
Okay, here we go. Leo's famous rice. The dike is...
Excuse me?
I meant the price of your order of the rice is $1.69.
No, it's not. It's $1.49.
Where'd you see that one?
In the circular, front page.
The rice you want is for the smaller box. If you want, I could just go.
I'm not paying for an extra 20 cents.
But ma'am, your order is already well over 100.
Listen to me, you ass. I want that box of rice for that price. You're gonna give me what I want, or you're gonna call your manager over here right now. Crack addicted nuisance to society, I own you.
I'm gonna call my manager.
"27 years since my last hernia. I got that from carrying a horse across a cornfield. Now that was a real job. No, wait a second. That was my second hernia. My first hernia was when..."
"1977, I had the worst urinary tract infection. They told me I should have died 20 years ago.
Loaf of bread here in the next 5 seconds, there's gonna be hell to pay.
Sir, would you like some help lifting that?
Kid, how many times do I have to tell you I don't need your help? I've done
yes,
this.
Yes, I know. You've been doing this since my grandpa was in diapers.
Where are you going?
Look, man, you obviously need help with those groceries.
Get back behind the register.
I'm going to be the one to admit it, because no one else is.
I don't need your help.
I'm just going to take this, ring you up, get you out of here, so you and me can go on with our pointless lives.
You get back behind the register.
Move it or lose it, old man.
Over my dead body.
No! No!
Give me the damn bag! Let go of it.
No.
Let go of it, old man. Yes, let go of it.
What the hell is going on here? What, are we attacking customers now? Are you all right, sir? Is there anything I could do for you? I am terribly sorry about this. You're at this dog food, free of charge. I'm terribly sorry again, I'm sorry.
If I ever catch you doing something like that again, your butt is out of here. Yeah. You understand me?
Yeah, I believe that. I'm the best cashier you got around here. Hell, we both know that I would be the one with the dumbass clipboard and the comfy office if I kissed as much corporate ass as you do. So don't even give me that.
Well, if he keels over, it's on you. I'm going on my lunch break. Don't bother calling me.
I wouldn't dream of it.
Ow! Hey!
Good job, son. I like the fight in you. I'm ready to pay.
Oh, thank God. Cash, credit, or check?
Cash.
Thank you.
Hello? Tim, you've got to help me. There's this psycho lady bitch and she's threatening me over a box of rice and you've got to get over here now.
What the hell's going on over there?
Nothing. Tim, did you hear that? That's the voice of evil. Come on, Ted. You've dealt with people like this 1,000 times over.
Ted, this is Chris. Ted is my bag boy.
Huh? Listen, Chris, you've dealt with people like this 1,000 times over. Why should this be any different?
I don't know why, but it is.
I don't want to hear it. You know what to do. Now get the job done.
What?
No buts. No buts. Now leave me the shit alone. I want to eat my sandwich.
Tim, please don't hang up on me this time.
Why shouldn't I?
I don't know. I mean, there was that one thing people were talking about you getting rejected by the Yeti girl.
Who told you about that?
I don't know, just a couple of guys in the break room. I don't know.
First off, her name is Christina. And where do you come up with this stuff? Okay, big deal. She didn't reject me, okay? I rejected her. She was too clingy and damn it to hell, I'll be right there.
I'm really sorry about this, ma'am. My manager will be here any minute. If you could just hang on a little while longer, it'll be fine.
Finally, I'm sick of dealing with 5-year-olds already. Shut the fuck up!
What seems to be the problem?
All I want is this box of rice for a fair price. But Rain Man over here won't let me. And quite frankly, he's pissing me off.
I am terribly sorry, ma'am, if we caused you any problems. It is really hard to find good help these days. I'll tell you what, I could fix it for you right now. Which item are you having a quarrel with?
The rice.
Have a nice night.
Eat me. Move it, dirtbag.
Tim! That lady was completely out of control. Why didn't you do anything?
What are you talking about?
She was threatening me. I needed you for backup.
Chris, how long have you been working here?
I don't know, 5 months?
5 months? Do you know where I was after 5 months? Off the register. Working right under the manager, training for customer service. That's where I was, Chris. Do you know why? Because I did my job and put in the extra effort. I was the go-to guy, Chris. Within a year, I was supervising the dairy department.
Is that where you met the Yeti girl?
My point is that I'm moving my way up. I'm manager now, but it's not stopping there. I am climbing that ladder of success. Within a year, by November, I'll be district rep.
Very good, Tim.
Damn it, Chris! I want to see you succeed here! With success comes trust. And right now, I can't trust you or dipshit over there. I know your type. I grew up with them in high school. Just walking through life hoping to fall ass backwards at the money? Newsflash! That's not life. You want to know what life is? It's coming to work. Every day, convincing yourself is just for the time being because you are meant for bigger and better things. Time goes by, becomes increasingly harder to convince yourself. Years pass and your supervisors seem to get younger while you yourself are getting older. You never hear your name mentioned anymore unless it's whispered behind your back. People on register use you as motivation to stay in school. Where the hell did that bag boy go? Oh well, it doesn't matter. Where was I? Oh yeah. Next thing you know, you're working the double graveyard shift just so you don't have to cry yourself asleep in your desolate shoebox apartment. Your only friends are the goldfish you can't keep alive. And every day gets agonizing more than the day before it. When finally, your landlord comes to collect your overdue rent and finds you hanging from your shoelaces. That's life.
Yeah, I'm not following.
Well, what more can I say to you, Chris?
Some people are just manager material.
And then there are those who just don't quite make the cut. Oh yeah, you can go on lunch break. If you're not back here in 15 minutes, I'm taking it out of your paycheck. And you, stop picking your fucking nose.
Where the hell did you go?
Are you open, sweetie?
Paper or plastic?
Paper in plastic.